Hello, I'm David Brown from the SOLIDWORKS training team. In this video, I'll show you how to take advantage of using bounding box properties in a model to populate data in a cutlass table on a drawing. Let's get started. Here I have a drawing of a woodworking project that I did with my grandkids. In my shop, I need some key information that you can see represented in the cutlass table. I need quantities of pieces with length, width, and material. I can get this information easily by using a bounding box. Notice that the length and width fields for the top are not yet populated. Let's take a look at the model. I'll click the ISO view and click Open Part from the pop-up menu. When I expand one of the cutlass items, you can see there is a material and a bounding box assigned to that cutlass item. SOLIDWORKS groups like items together in a cutlass, so these properties apply to all bodies in the cutlass item. For my purposes, I have created a library of custom materials that I use on a regular basis. I will demonstrate how I created these in an upcoming video. To add a bounding box for the top cutlass item, I right-click the folder and click Create Bounding Box from the context menu. A bounding box is a 3D sketch representing the smallest box one of the bodies will fit in. Here I have selected the bounding box of the leg 1 item. You can see the dotted lines of the box around one of the leg bodies. The bounding box provides thickness, width, length, and volume properties. If I right-click one of the cutlass folders and select Properties from the context menu, I can see the properties that are available for each cutlass item. Switching back to the drawing, all fields are now populated in the cutlass table. Allow me to show you how to add the bounding box properties to the drawing of the drawer. The default cutlass table has a column for length, but is not currently mapped to the bounding box property. I'll click the column header and click Cutlass Item Property from the Column Properties panel at left. Select the bounding box length property from the drop-down and name the title of the column as appropriate. I'll add another column with a right-click of the column header and select Insert Column Right, and do the same thing for bounding box width. Lastly, I'll add another column for the material. Now I have a simple drawing with exactly what I need to cut the pieces for the drawer. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access more content regarding SOLIDWORKS drawings.